Jonathan said, feel the fear, feel the uncertainty, feel all this with me, guys. I'm from a different world, a different space, not so high-tech, artificial intelligence. What's that? Right? So bear with me, open yourselves up, just dig deep to the human inside of each of us, and then we'll be speaking the same language. One of those someone who still loves radio. I know Suresh better put his hand up if I ask. And me, along with 300,000 and counting people who live in these beautiful hills of Uttarakhand, the Himalayas, and the Mandakini River Valley region, where my organization, People's Park Collective, we work in the not so glamorous, often overlooked, but absolutely empowering and liberating space called Community Radio. And it's great to be here. I'm Saritha Thomas, and this story is about our experiences in the hills of Uttarakhand, our experiences with Community Radio, and voice empowerment, and the ability to be change makers right at the grassroots. So if there's anything you take away from this talk, I hope it's positiveness and hope for a better world for everyone and not just you and me. I'm going to start with a pressing question, not difficult, but pressing. Something I ask myself a lot, and I'm asking you to ask yourselves, what is my purpose? What is your purpose? And what are we all chasing? Yeah, what are we chasing? Peace, prosperity, happiness, love, yeah? Good health, wealth, happiness, all those things that come with Ganesh Chaturthi and everything else. Contentment, some of us might say. What my personal experience, though, is in chasing my purpose, sometimes and most, almost always, leads me to these things, right? And I've been chasing my purpose now for a long time, from my early 20s, many, many moons ago. And it began with media school in Bombay, where I studied radio. One of the only people in the class putting my hand up saying radio. So not cool, so not fashionable. But yes, there I was. And that journey of radio has taken me across this country, across the UAE, to the UK. All these years learning about this medium, how powerful it is, how vibrant it is, how it really is this unsung hero. Learning about myself, as an individual, as a woman, as somebody with skills, as somebody with weaknesses, and being able to embrace all that. And suddenly I find myself working at the BBC Radio in London, BBC World Service. Why am I saying it so many times? Dream come true for any radio buff. It's the Mecca, it's the Kedarnath, it's the Vatican, it's the Bodh Gaya, whatever you want to call off radio, right? And a seven-year-old's dream coming true, working at the BBC, purpose found, slam dunk, happiness, not quite. I could feel something in my bones, I was on the right track, but this was not quite it. And then suddenly the penny dropped, right? This feeling of empowerment, of happiness, of finding myself, how could it end with me? How could it end with me and my story? It had to spread. This radio gaga-ness had to be infected in others, and why not in the most powerful, interactive avatar of radio, community radio, right? And that's when one started exploring how we could be part of this movement that was ongoing in India, and I had been following it for years and years and years. But there is a time and place, and I think all of us would feel that in our life's journey, when the penny drops, you make big decisions, you make life-changing decisions, you leave the BBC, you come back to India, you start an organization. And that's when, that's how People's Power Collective was born. And we work in community radio in those beautiful Himalayas. We are a training capacity building organization. And we work and live with communities. And the case in point being Mandakini Ki Awaaz, a radio station that we started in collaboration with a community group in the hills, which is now in its fifth year of broadcasting, owned, managed, and run by a community. And the hills are truly alive with the sound of music and a lot else. So, quick background, what is community radio to all you tech smarty pantses? Very simple. The design of community radio is in the details of it. So engage with us and see what we are about. So an FM radio station managed and run by an isolated or rural community, daily programming in their local language, producing creative, informative, entertaining, engaging, interactive and relevant content, relevant not to you and me and the bigger world design, but relevant to them. That is what is community radio, right? Owned, managed, run by community groups themselves. Language, one thing I want to focus on here, the value of communication in my own language or my dialect. This is power at the grassroots, right? Not in Hindi, not in Ponzi English, but in Gadwali or in Kumaoni or in any other tongue that is native to these people. Language is the biggest discriminator in today's world. Here you find it in the design, embedded beautifully in community radio, giving voice. I wouldn't say giving, I'd say allowing people to realize that they too have a voice, right? That is the power in this medium. It also focuses on issues, women's issues, education, disaster management, and in building sustainable, holistic communities, public health, we all know globally concern, as is the case in absolute grassroots of India, livelihoods, arts and culture preservation, very, very important to our fabric. And when I talk about arts and culture, often when we talk in development circles, where some of you might overlap, the moment you go into entertainment, right, it's frowned upon. Oh, it's not about public health, and oh my God, it's geet, sangeet, song, dance. We forget that entertainment is the basic thread of all the fabrics of our communities, isn't it? I mean, imagine your life without what you call entertainment. And this takes it the whole next level. It's not entertainment on television where you see Eminem or whomever you're into and you're like, wow, who is the entertainer? You. You, the community. Who is the musician? You. Who's telling stories, folk stories? You. Imagine the power you've got. I mean, assume I just put a microphone in front of you, ma'am, and ask you to say something very eloquent, very gripped, right now. What is going to happen? What are you going to feel? I can see nerves on your face. I can see nerves on your face. And that is the journey of a radio broadcaster. I've been there. Sweaty palms, not sure how people are going to receive my voice, my tone, leave alone the message, right? And you come out of your first radio program, you get a call from your mom saying, hey, you sounded pretty good. That is empowerment for me. That was my journey, as is for so many men and women working right now in these community radio stations. Again, coming back to the technicality, it's a two-way medium, most powerful. Again, you're not being talked at, you're part of the dialogue, you're part of the design framework yourself. Not some big designer, not some Saritha Thomas from the BBC. Who is she? Nobody knows. But they know the Umas, the Poonams, the Manvendas, the Shivanands of the village. They are the stars. They are the designers of their own programming. They are the designers of their own future, right? So this is what it is. And very importantly, inclusive cuts across every single barrier you could possibly conceive, right? Man, woman, literate or not, we had Rameshwariji at one of our trainings, illiterate, and that just challenged us no end. What is going to be the model? How are we going to turn this around quickly? We had no idea till Rameshwariji rocked up that morning that she was joining one of the cohorts. And it was so fantastic because we immediately buddied her with somebody Rameshwari ji had all this pictorial stuff we were doing. My technical trainer was like, my God, I don't want to draw a radio tower. And there he was drawing his radio tower. And it was just fantastic. And Rameshwari turned out to be one of the most intuitive reporters at Mandakini Ki Awaaz because she has a ear and a heart for a good story, a story that moves people. And so she'd come back and saying, we are going to do this, this, this. And then somebody else is writing the script. And somebody else is helping her. And this is how inclusive this space can be, right? And then look at your little mobile phone there. That's the only kind of new media thing I can deal with. But that is just converges so beautifully with community radio because immediately your little FM built-in receiver in your mobile allows you to listen. And when you call the radio station, there you are, citizen journalist, reporting something. Namaste, main hoon Saritha Thomas, main yahan pe khadi hoon. I am Saritha Thomas, I'm standing here. The road is broken down. Please make sure the bus bringing the kids doesn't come down this road. Very important life-saving information through my own radio station in my own Gadwali. And please note, when I end the call, I will repeat 20 times. Did you write my name? Saritha Thomas, Gaon Biri, from this village. Have you written my name? Why? So important for me to be on this station, to identify, to belong, and have 300,000 other people saying, I heard you on the radio, you sounded good. You changed the whole scope of that road thing. That was fantastic. Empowerment, right? It begins there. The moment I moved in that manner, I am beginning to ask bigger questions. Okay, how can I be part of a bigger dialogue? How can I bring water to my village? How can I have doctors in our public health centers? How can I be part of my own change, right? With information comes power, comes knowledge, comes responsibility. You stop sitting back and thinking somebody else has to do this. Oh, I'm in the boonies of Uttarakhand. Nobody cares. Bechare. This bechara attitude, all of us Indian here will know what it is, feeling sorry for oneself, that attitude is immediately on hold when you become part of your own media landscape. You've been given the power, you now have the choice to act. Again, just reiterating the value of radio, specifically community radio in today's high-tech world, it's still so relevant. And not just in India, in other countries like Mexico, a lot of South American countries, Southeast Asian countries, it still remains the most powerful, intuitive new media, if you ask me. It's traditional media, but it's new media. Don't ignore it. Don't sidestep it. It's got tremendous power and value. So quick few stories of change from our hills. This wonderful woman here, I'm not showing you a Pahari woman with 80 kilos of ghas on her back, which you all must be used to seeing. Yeah, we all see images of Pahadis crouched with ghas. Don't get me wrong, Uma does that every day, twice, even today. But she spends 8 hours of her day at the radio station as a producer, as a researcher, as a program maker, as the head of content, and she still has time for all these other things. And Uma, to me, is a hero. She's one of my heroes. She's a change maker. She's not just inspired me, but she inspires hundreds of women up and down those hills. Agar Uma kar sakti, to main bhi kar sakti hu. If Uma can do this, so can I, right? Huge, huge equalizer, friends. And Uma has, I don't know which story of Uma to tell. I have so many in my brain. I guess the one to share is how she says one of her life's goals was to work in a daftar, to work in an office. Today she's like, my God, I mean, I have surpassed that by miles. I'm in a live, dynamic radio station, and I have the power and the responsibility to inspire so many other women like myself. I couldn't have dreamed of this position. And she takes it as immense responsibility. It's not a luxury. It's not something to be only proud of, but it's something to share and something to inspire other people by. Other anecdotal stories. Danilalji, alcoholic, listening to radio programming, deciding to change his life. U-turn, comes to the radio station every single month now with something or the other, a box of sweets, a vegetable from his farm, something to give to what he calls his shrine, which has changed his life. Again, roads being built in our villages, water being available in certain places, all because of campaigns on the radio station, reportage, community citizen journalism, balanced journalism, where your radio programmer will call your PwC person, will call your district collector, what is your comment, how do we resolve this? The case is not sensational journalism at all. It's about journalism for change, where you can enable things to happen versus name call, sensationalize, which is pretty much what our journalism is today, right? Shameful, but true. Women at the station, eat your heart out, guys. 7 men, 25 women. And this is a growing number. From 25,000 artists, you have 7 men for every 25 women. And these women, believe you me, they just enjoy their time on their radio station. And again, coming back to entertainment and information, entertainment is the easiest way to break into something like this, right? You don't come there to the station and rock up with your most pressing private worry or your health issue, but it's easy to sing a song. It's easy to recite a poem that you really resonate with, and then you realize, hey, this is pretty cool. I have a voice, people appreciate it, and you open yourself up. It is a process. It is not one size fits all. It is not a silver bullet that you fire today and the world has changed, but it is a wonderful dynamic process. And all these people are signing up for this. Women's health on the radio station, Dr. Didi, as she's called, Dr. Didi is saving lives up and down these hills. And this, for these women, never heard of before. No one ever addressed their personal issues the way she does. And again, radio offers you anonymity, right? So you have something really personal you can't share, or you thought you couldn't before, pick up the phone, don't disclose who you are, share your issue, and you're possibly helping out a whole bunch of other people. The role of community radio in disaster management, again, a very, very big issue. Communities at the heart of their disaster management is really the way forward. Again, name calling, blame game, it all needs to end. We need to take responsibility for what we do. And radio lends itself so beautifully for that. We were there in 2013. For those of you who are aware, there was the Kedarnath floods, one of the worst floods. My team and I were there. And I'll just rewind, the floods happened on the 16th of June, 16th and 17th. My team and I were there to begin our training program on the 1st. And on the 2nd of June, I remember waking up in my room and there was cacophony outside. And I peeped out, and guess what I saw? On the opposite side of the valley, just wild guess, anybody. A tiger and her cub, right? Right opposite on the other valley, a tiger and her cub. And there I was, I mean, my husband and I are huge tiger buffs, right? And I was like, oh my God, how can things get better than this? This is where I live, this is where I work. And yeah, things got really bad. 16th of June was those horrific floods. We were lucky because we live at a slightly higher ground, but it was devastating, and all the field work that followed was really not what we signed up for. But then again, the universe, doesn't it have this beautiful way of conspiring? I mean, put us in that place to feel the uncertainty, to feel the fear, and learn from that experience, and learn firsthand how powerful grassroots, local language, low-tech is at the time of natural disasters, or indeed, all year round, to help us be resilient, be prepared, be more aware, and live a more sustainable life to support this ecosystem that we live in. And this trust factor is probably one of the biggest points here. When you switch on your local radio station and you've been listening to Uma every single day on a good day about fun things, about happy things, and then Uma's telling you, get up and run, the odds are you're going to just do that. The trust that your community radio station builds is unparalleled. Our approach has been seeded deeply in design thinking, and with empathy at its heart. And I'm not using empathy here as a buzzword, folks. I mean, in fact, when we began our process, I don't think I even knew there was something called design thinking 10 years ago. But what took place then was an ethnographic research, living and working with 7 different communities across India, visiting their radio stations, or indeed what plans they had to build a radio station, trying to understand their context as best we could, trying to feel what it is to live this life in such a marginalized, isolated manner, and understand from them what they were seeking or looking to find through their design process with community radio. What were they trying to achieve? What were their challenges? And where were the holes? And that was the basis at which People's Power Collective was built, understanding that human context so we could be intuitive and deliver something that was actually needed. We also visited the Mazdoor Kisan Shakti Sangathan in Rajasthan, where right to information was born. And this is their process was exactly this, living and working and engaging with communities. So our model is an immersion-based model. We live in the villages, we live in their homes, we walk to work every day. There's a 5-hour hike to the radio station and back, field visits, walk for 14 kilometers a day. But this is the power of engagement at the absolute grassroots, where you can live the same life, feel the same feeling, be intuitive, be positive in their process, and handhold and guide through that. So this kind of immersion-based training capacity building was a place where we kind of stuck our necks out, ditched the status quo, and said, this is what we're going to do. We were frowned upon by many. Fund givers disappeared, but we stuck our necks out and we did what we did. And today we have an MOU with the government of Uttarakhand to set up 5 new community radio stations in other isolated parts of Uttarakhand. Thank you. To deliver a similar, intuitive, people at its heart model for radio. And this is what it's all about, folks. It's about cracking open individuals and them then being part of their communities, this community being an intrinsic part of their community radio stations, and community radio stations helping community-driven development and change. This is what it's about. This is as low-tech as it gets and as inclusive as it gets. And I think, it's about celebration, it's about communities coming together. This picture is all of us on the launch date of Mandakini Ki Awaaz, and I'm looking forward to similar pictures with a million other people in these hills as we go about setting more stations. And I think the key for all of us is to continuously dig deep, keep looking for what we are here to do. What is that purpose, right? What have we learned? Stack your strengths, your successes, your skills, your learning, your experience on the one hand, and then look at the world through an inclusive lens on the other, and see, what can you do? What can I do? Where is our place in whatever design interface we are in? Where is our place to change things, not just for ourselves, but for other people? Are we part of this journey? So yeah, so let's design smart, let's design from the heart. Small tech, simple techniques, a lot of spirit and soul. Passion, ownership, commitment, creativity, discipline, and a tenacity in making big dreams come true, and not just for me and for you. Thank you so much.